Hello everyone, in this topic we are going to learn how to represent carbon compounds using different structural representations. So there are four main ways of representing a compound. So the first one is dire structural formula, the second one is condensed structural representation, the third one is bond line representation, and the last one is 3D representation. Now let's try to understand how all the different ways of representations using a given example. In this example, we have taken C3, H8 and O. So how do we represent this particular molecule using different representations that we have just learned? So in the dire structural formula, we are essentially expanding every atom in such a way to represent all the atoms involved in that given compound. So here we can see CH3, COHH and CH3. If you look at it closely, you can see that this is nothing but an extended version of Lewis dot structure. Now if we try to represent this using condensed structure, how does it differ as compared to dash representation? So here we are essentially avoiding all the CH bond and we are representing only CC bond and C with other functional groups or heteroatoms. So this is condensed representation. And this is also, if we represent like this, CH3, CH, OH, CH3, this is also nothing but a condensed representation. Now the third one is bond line representation. So you can see that as we go down, the bond line representation is actually representing using simple bonds. So what do these bonds correspond to? In these bonds, we are assuming that carbon and hydrogen are already present, or they are actually satisfying the octet already. So this is nothing but CH3, CH, OH and CH3. You can see that carbon atoms and hydrogen atoms are not represented in this type of bond line representation. The last way is nothing but 3D representation. So here it's very important to understand, because in 3D representation, we are actually representing the tetrahedral structure, that is sp3 tetrahedral structure of a carbon in a 2D plane, obviously. So if you look at this representation, you have to assume that these two bonds are actually lying on the plane, and the dash wedge is the dash wedge is actually going behind the plane, and the solid wedge is actually coming towards the plane or outside the plane or towards the viewer. We will learn in detail about how to represent 3D how to actually represent compounds in 3D and what are its importance and significance in later topics. So for now, I hope you are clear with how to represent a given molecular formula using various ways like dash, condensed, bond line and 3D representations.